Summit Real Estate smashes another record, this time by tens of millions. Phil Lindeman, Krystal, 93 News. First, CDOT is partnering with Frisco for workforce housing just off Main Street. CDOT owns a half-acre parcel on 7th and Granite, where seasonal employees like plow drivers lived in mobile homes until last year. A new agreement calls for workforce rentals there, and construction bids are open now, due by December 7th. Contact the town. In just 48 hours, Summit County is going red.
Let's just focus on what we need to do to get through this. And the biggest single thing is avoiding interacting, especially indoors, especially in close vicinity with people outside your household.
That was Governor Jared Polis from a press conference yesterday. Level red was considered lockdown only 2 days ago, but not anymore.
We know the high health and economic costs of lockdowns and want to avoid them. We also know that we have additional capacity in our hospital system in terms of ICU and non-ICU beds. And most importantly, if we didn't have cause to believe that this would work, then we wouldn't be taking this step.
Polis also updated the Colorado COVID dial, adding level purple. That means hospitals are overrun and lockdown is imminent.
No counties are currently in purple or in that condition.
Summit and up to 15 other counties enter level red this Friday with no indoor dining or events and limited capacity for gyms, salons, and critical business. Chairlifts will keep spinning. All four local ski areas have COVID operating plans just for this reason, but the trolls are trolling on the Summit Daily website. One commenter says resorts are, quote, offering a really poor product to destination skiers. He then hated on ski reservations, limited dining, and grumpy lifties. Several deleted responses accused the man of fear-mongering. In the lone remaining response, Matt writes, throw a sandwich in your jacket and just get after it. Tune in today at 4 and 5 for our review of COVID operating plans and what they mean for employees. October annihilated local real estate records. This from Summit Association of Realtors. 160 homes in Summit sold for nearly $180 million last month, beating the previous record from 2017 by nearly $69 million. It buries last October by $107 million. Breckenridge set a staggering pace. 46 homes sold for an average of $1.6 million. Sales price countywide was up double digits. Sales volume up 120 to 440%. Colorado sucks at recycling, and we're making more trash than ever. The Colorado Sun reports on 2019 findings from a statewide waste survey showing recycling rate fell from 17 to 16%, far below the national average of 35%. Average waste per person is up 5%, and Front Rangers are the biggest culprits. Rural residents toss 4.7 pounds of waste per day, compared to 6 pounds elsewhere. That's equal to more than a ton of trash per person every year. The latest now on coronavirus and questions. Summit health officials hold a virtual town hall meeting tomorrow at 9 a.m. explaining what level red means for you, Summit schools, and local business. That meeting is tomorrow, 9 a.m., hosted by the Summit Chamber. Get details on the Summit Chamber Facebook page. Summit County's latest infection rate is 1,117 per 100,000 people, with a positive test rate of 13.9%. Summit Medical Center is at 21% capacity, 60% below the high-risk mark. And in local sports, brought to you by American Family Insurance, the Weiss Agency, Summit High football heads to Battle Mountain this Friday for a rivalry game in enemy territory. The Tigers enter 1-2. The Huskies are 2-4. Game time is 6 o'clock. Phil Lindeman, Krystal, 93 News.